Welcome to Twin Cam. Where are we today?
We're at Naval Air Station, Patuxent River, Maryland.
We're here to find out how the Navy is developing an aid to help pilots land these things, this F-18 Hornet and other aircraft, on an aircraft carrier. Stay tuned.
We're here today to check out the magic carpet software, as the Navy calls it. This is basically, to put it more simply, a landing aid for carrier pilots. It helps them more reliably and more consistently land an aircraft on deck. It would do so by what? I know from having had the experience that the pilot no longer has to make throttle adjustments. What does the software do for the pilot? I know there are a couple of pieces of flying in, glide slope and lineup. So what does the software help them do?
Yeah, so the key parts are, as we talked about, is integrate direct lift. So we're changing the camber of the wing surfaces. So we're getting lift as fast as we can modulate the aerodynamic surfaces, which we don't do today. The pilot has to change pitch and power to get those. We allow the flight control computer to do that manipulation. So we give him direct command and control of what he wants, which is flight path. That's what we've always desired, and that's what he's controlling to. So you ask for flight path changes to manage glide slope. The flight control computer figures out what flap deflections, what pitch attitude, and what power to put on to meet the command you asked for.
And we'll show you some video of this, but if you see it from outside, you see the F-18 Super Hornet or an F-35 with this system make changes where you can see the elevons on the tail and the flaps moving very, very quickly. And that's part of that direct lift control you talk about, which helps you lock in an angle of attack, which you need to land an aircraft on an aircraft carrier, but go up or down without porpoising too much or changing that angle of attack, if I've got it right.
That's right, you've got it right. Instead of pitching a 44,000 pound airplane, we're actually deflecting the aerodynamic surfaces to give that response much quicker than what we do today. And that's really the key enabler. It's integrated direct lift embedded with what we want is giving the pilot direct command of the flight path.
And one more thing, buddy, how many approaches have been flown using the Magic Carpet software so far?
Yeah, so we've done two ship trials. One was a demonstration trial, proof of concept. We 180 approaches on that effort based on the really very good results we got off that. We set forward to building the control system to go to the fleet. We just got done doing almost 600 approaches there. So just at the ship, we've got close to 800 approaches in various conditions to prove the system out, not only conditions on the flight deck, but we looked at worst case laterally symmetric loadings, also our heavyweight growler. So we've flown the full gamut of both aircraft loadings and wind over deck combinations to prove out the system that we can release to the fleet.
And those sorties and those on-ship periods were flown right here from Pax River, yes?
So we flew out of Pax River with our test pilots. Last year was aboard the USS Bush, and then this year USS George Washington.
There you have it. You'll see a lot more about Magic Carpet in the video. Pay attention, we'll throw some clips in. Buddy, thanks so much for taking the time. Appreciate it. Well, we've gotten this far at NAS Patuxent River. We're in the workstation for the FA-18EF Super Hornet simulator, and we're gonna go in just a minute and try our hand at flying a carrier approach with and without the Magic Carpet software. Well, you don't know.
Set that rate command, obviously, to stop it.
that you just released. So this allows you to set the flight path anywhere you want. Pull back and hold. Pull it up about right here and hold it. There you go.
A hold.
Yeah, so now we're on the flight path so you can release. We've gone high, so push forward and hold. So there's that untraining the metrics. So now the ball's coming in, ball's coming in. Keep it coming down. So the mechanics in your brain are doing what you did in a regular airplane, is that input and release, back and release.
Well, I'm just trying to compensate it. It doesn't
want you to compensate. So what you have to do is break that tendency to stab at it. It's a steady input for a steady increase in glide slope. And as you see it in, you just steadily center, you bring it back to center. So roughly about there, within, that should be close.
So
I think he has to reset.